Really go on, you watch the culture on Charisma TV.
Good morning, Belize, and good morning. I say good morning, Belize, and good morning. And how are you this morning?
What up, everyone? Charisma here, and welcome back to another episode of For the Culture. Now, today I'm here with Shanda, and she is from Belize. So, I lived in Belize for a couple of years before I came to Canada for school, and I fell in love with the people, the place. Like, it has such a rich culture, and I thought, why not share that with you guys? And also, I've been asked a lot of questions about Belize, and I don't have all the answers, so I brought in an expert and a true Belizean to let you guys know all the answers to your questions. So, Shanda is going to, like, tell us the location, the language that they speak, and later and we're going to get down into like the people of Belize, because as I mentioned, they do have a very diverse culture and people. So take it away, Shannon. Thanks for being here with me today.
Thank you for inviting me, Maggie. I don't know about expert, but you know, I will give it my best try. So so as Maggie said, I'm originally from Belize, and Belize is this beautiful, green, lovely country that is located in Central America. So we're nestled just between Mexico and Guatemala. Now, Belize has always been sort of considered like one in terms of a controversy. So, okay, well, what language does it speak, right? Mm-hmm. Because, you know, some people come here and then some people speak Spanish initially, some people are speaking English, and then, of course, some of them are speaking Creole, which is a completely different thing. But Belize's official language is English, and a very long time ago, Belize was colonized by Britain, and so that's how it became had the official language as being English. Now, because we are in Central America, which is primarily all Spanish-speaking countries, then we also have Spanish as a second language in our country. So, more than likely, every single person you speak from Belize will speak English first, and then more likely they'll have Spanish and then some other variation or some other different language based on their ethnic group.
Okay.
So in terms of some of the location, Belize has a beautiful Caribbean Sea next to it, and then we have the second largest barrier reef in the Northern Hemisphere, which is awesome.
Yes.
Beautiful. And then across from the barrier reef, there is the Atlantic Ocean. So, you know, we're always thinking, hoping that people would always come and enjoy a beautiful country, beautiful, green, hot, warm country. In terms of people, there is, like I mentioned before, there is about 360,000 to 370,000 Belizeans living in Belize. And so when you think about that, it's not just the makeup of just one particular culture, mm-hmm. but there's a lot of different cultures that have come in and called Belize home. And that has just been happening from a very long time ago, from ever since the country started to become a land and recognized country.
Yeah.
Indigenous to Belize is the Mayas. Of course, the Mayas are indigenous to all of Central America. So that is one of our large ethnic groups within our culture.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the southern part, there is East Indians. So East Indians are, of course, from India, different parts of India. And so they've immigrated to Belize. We also have the Garifuna people, and the Garifuna people are people who have been brought over from Africa, and so those people have sort of moved in from different parts of the Caribbean and into Belize.
Okay.
Most of them came from Honduras.
Yes.
And into the southern part of Belize, that's primarily where the largest group of Garifunas live.
Okay.
As well as in the sort of the central western part, there's a lot of Creoles and then a lot of mestizos, and it's because those countries are more closer to Guatemala, where you would have a lot of mestizo influence or Spanish influence.
Okay.
In the northern part of the country, again, because of the close proximity to Mexico, it's also a lot of mestizos, where you have the Spanish influence again there. So we do have in sort of, I would call it the eastern part, which is Belize City, it's huge with Chinese, because we have a lot of Chinese who've moved into Belize, and that has been happening for years. So that is part of one of our unique and distinct cultural group. We also have Mennonites. So the Mennonite community, there is about three really large Mennonite communities in Belize. So they are a really established ethnic group as well.
Yeah. Okay. Nice.
Yeah.
She did a great job because usually you can't get like people to really properly explain. So that, thank you, Shonda. That was a good job.
Yeah.
So, Shonda.
Yeah.
What are you then? What ethnic group would you identify with? Because I've met people who are like, they have a little bit of mestizo, Mayan, like mix up. When I say mix up, guys, you will find someone who won't be like a particular group. You will never find someone who's just one particular group. They have family on that side and this side. So. Which group do you identify with?
So I identify primarily with Creole. So okay. So my dad is primarily Creole, and then my mom is Spanish.
Okay,
and so
lovely mix.
I know, a lovely mix of both of them, right? And so that's what I primarily identify myself as. But you know, even within that cultural group, there is a variation of us who range in different colors because of the mix. Like Maggie said, it's not just made up of just maybe one, like, you know, maybe black people just mixing together with themselves.
Yeah.
There is, you know, black people who might be with Spanish people or Indians or Mayas, and it just creates a new beautiful version of Creole people.
Yeah.
So that's how I identify primarily. My mom is Spanish, but my mom is her mother was like a Spanish mixed with Maya.
Oh.
And my grandmother was the shortest little thing. Like, she was so cute. And then my mom's dad, he's like red skin, but he's a Creole man.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then my dad, both his parents were black Creole people.
Yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm. Yes. So guys, if you're visiting Belize and you see all these different variation of shades, colors, different groups, like, it is because of this beautiful like intermingling and interaction of different people from different groups.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So before we go, we cannot let you go without busting a little Belizean curl for us. Like, so Belize's dialect is Belizean Creole, and when I just got there, it was very hard for me to understand it. I'll do a video on that eventually, comparing the Jamaican patois to Belizean Creole, but when you get used to it, trust me, like, I love it.
Mm.
I love both of them, but I won't even say which one's my favorite. I don't think I have one, but yeah, so we'll leave it at that. So, yes, leave us with a little Belizean Creole, please.
Oh, my gracious. So this has always been my challenge, I will say, that whenever I say, okay, we're Creole people, and just for you to know that Creole is C-R-E-O-L-E, but the language that we speak, Creole, is K-R-I-O-L.
Oh, Jesus.
So it's actually even spelled different.
Yeah.
And people are always saying, oh, say something in Creole, say something. It's not like Spanish where it's a completely different language. For Spanish, you can say, you know, me llamo es Shanda. Uh-huh. You can say, hola, como estás? But for somebody who speaks Creole, Creole is a broken, it's a broken up version of English.
Yeah.
Right? And so it's easier for us to speak Creole. So we're going to have a conversation in Creole, Maggie.
Let me that way, test my Creole skills. Yes,
exactly. So then that way we can, and you, if your listeners and your viewers can get an understanding of what it is.
Yeah.
So, I just come in yesterday and I got to cut me here. What do you think about it?
Girl, your hair look nice. I like this little length, like it fit you or tell it look like a big woman and thing.
I know, girl, and you know what? When I'm in the home of the Vancouver, I tell them, girl, that I'm going to cut me here. And then after that, and then they never believe me, so then I had to send pictures after that, you know. And then after that, my sister came early this morning and she was like, girl, look, I see your hair, how you look.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, what do you think? And then she was like, oh, I love it.
So you know? She may really like the haircut then.
She love it bad, yeah.
I like
but then my pahina like, you know, I love you and you're the medata, but I really would have preferred you have long hair. And I said, daddy, but no worry, money, I grow back.
But that's just hair, right?
That's just hair, that's exactly. Just hair. Can't grow back.
I don't know if I do a good job just now.
You did, it's awesome. It's awesome.
Like, it's really like cool. Like, once you get the hang of it, if you're listening to us or like you get a few words taught, like, it's similar. I would say some parts of it would be similar to like other Creoles in the Caribbean. So as she said, Belize would be identified as being Caribbean as well because of its location as well, and because they are part of CARICOM. So it's not too far off. You will be able to understand each other, but it's just a few phrases that would be different. But as I said, watch out for a video like that coming soon.
Excellent.
Sorry, thank you so much for doing this video with me, Shonda.
You're welcome. It was fun, and I hope that your viewers enjoyed.
I hope they did too. And if you did, click that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button, share this video with all your friends and family, and don't forget to tune in every single Saturday for a new video of Fidiculture. Don't forget to do road and do things, and until next time, Maggie is out.